Bismillahi Rahman Rahim Alhamdulillah Wassalatu Wassalam on all the messengers of Allah. My dear sisters and my brothers, Assalamu Alaikum wa Rahmatullah. Anyone that claims that Allah has predetermined a human's actions is actually making Allah an accomplice in every murder. If someone kills, they will just give the evidence or the excuse that they killed because that is what is written, what Allah has written for them to do. The person that died, died because their time has arrived and that Allah had already written how they're gonna die. And they will just say to you, so why are you holding me responsible? This way, there'll be no justice on earth. Anyone can kill anybody, and the killer, they will just say, I killed because, and you put the, you fill the words. That is Allah who has written that this person be dead under my hands or with my hands. Of course, then that would make the Quran a complete joke because Allah says in the Quran, An-nafsu bin-nafs. The killer must pay with their own selves for taking the lives of others. Also, fornication. Someone will just come to you if you are a husband and wife and your spouse cheats on you. All they have to say is just, look, I actually didn't want to cheat on you, but it is Allah who had decreed this, and as such, I only carry the decree of Allah. Apply this to the thief, to the liar, to anyone else out there. If you commit a crime in the street and you gave this excuse to the government, to the authorities, will they take that? Of course not. Because we all are responsible for our deeds. That's why there is a judgment day. Child abuse, sex exploitation for weak kids and weak women, all these people. So do you reckon that Allah had written that people should abuse a child, rape them? In that young age that Allah had written that and the person was just carrying Allah's will? Of course not. Again, cheating, parental abuses, lies, deceits, transgression, oppression. Jamal Khashoggi was killed, brutally assassinated by the Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia. What has the Crown Prince done, I wonder? Well, just carried away Allah's decree. Again, greed, theft, pride, envy, fornication. And worst of all is accusing Allah that he wrote the scenario to all things, just like a movie maker, a director who writes the scripts and brings the actors and sets the scenes and looks for location, adjusts the soundings and lightings and all those things to shoot the film ideally, perfectly. That's what they made out of Allah. But the question is, why did they do that? Why it is today grinded in the Muslim minds or also in the Jews and Christian minds that whatever is happening was already decreed? Well, simply put, as simple as it can be, and I encourage you to go on YouTube and check my series about the decree and predestinations. There are about 10 talks. I cover this issue from all angles. You see, sometimes one word is enough. At other times, a whole surgery needs to be done to remove the cancer that is in-depthly grinding in the Muslim beliefs and minds. All this starts one day with Mr. Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan. After the assassination of Ali, after the assassination of Al-Hassan, who was the crown prince, so to speak, Muawiyah had turned the Khilafah, so to speak, into a kingdom. He became the first king. Revolts after revolts, and there were tons of revolts. Thawrat al-Fuqaha, the revolt of the Fuqaha, the scholars. The revolt of all, you won't believe it, in the first 15 years after the death of Ali, how much Muawiyah had suffered. What you know about history is what politics and the employed agents, so to speak, or the employed spies of this institution, that is the government, the sheikhs and the preachers and all those people, what they did was to twist the meanings of Islam so that they justify the historical events that took place. When Muawiyah stole the kingdom from Ali, when Ali was assassinated, and the Shia movement was invented, and the Sunni movement was invented, and we Muslims, even though we have one Quran, we got divided into two portions about the whole concept of who was the person that was fit to rule Muslims. What happened was Muawiyah took control. And to justify that deed, scholars invented one vile lie. And then so that lie keeps existing in us, they changed the whole concepts that Allah spoke about in the Quran to always mean that lie. That lie is nothing happens without Allah writing it first. And as such, it was driven into people's minds that Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan is the king, or as they sugarcoated it, the Khalifa, because it was written in Allah's knowledge that Muawiyah should be a leader, and that it was not for Ali to be leader because Allah didn't write it. Then the whole entire Islam was built on this, and everything else just followed. As such, Allah did not write that Muawiyah become a king, and Allah did not write that Ali be assassinated. Allah did not write Al-Hassan be assassinated. Allah did not write, and on forth. As such, my dear sisters and my brothers, Allah is innocent from all human actions. He is innocent 1000%. That's why there is a judgment day to ask us on the choices we made, why we made them, and the consequences of those choices that we made. On judgment day, Allah will ask you about where you got all these accusations, where you got all these things that Allah has written on you, what you did, that you fornicated because it's written on you. Allah will ask you about these accusations and why you made him a part or another party in your crime. And then if you answer that the scholars said this or that, Allah will tell you, I did not command you to follow the scholars. I sent you a message. I emailed you a message through a human being, the Quran. I texted you a message, the Quran, through a human being. Won't be enough. Hadith in al-Bukhari that was written 200 years, started writing 250 years, almost 300 years after the death of Rasulullah. We laugh at the Christians for having a Bible that was written in the 3rd century, and we do exactly the same, Bukhari, Muslim, or Hadith books. And for your information, we don't have the original copies of Bukhari, Muslim, Abu Dawud, Tirmidhi, Nasa'i, and all those people. We don't have the original copy. We just have what has been transmitted to us. Just to tell you, the Bukhari that you know today is actually a falsified version, since the original does not exist. How did this Bukhari get to us? Well, it all is Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. It's his error, it's his fault for having collected 13 different versions of al-Bukhari, and he added, retrieved, deleted, made this one, corrected that one, changed this name here, this word doesn't work. So he actually was the one to have composed one Bukhari out of 13 Bukharis. That's why in the Salafi world, they always present Ibn Hajar Asqalani as the Amir al-Mu'mineen, the highest authority in Hadith, so that you don't question his knowledge, you don't question the Bukhari he has composed for you. On judgment day, al-Bukhari said, won't be sufficient. Because Allah will ask you, did I say that? You will say, no. It's in al-Bukhari. And Allah said, did I ask you to follow al-Bukhari or Muslim or any other books of hadith? And you will say, no. Because you know, you've read in the Quran that you, just like the Prophet Muhammad, like any other prophets, were to follow the commands of Allah. If you told him, Ya Allah, you said this in al-Quran, Allah's going to tell you, show me. Where did I say that? Where exactly? Show me. And you will not be able to, because it just does not exist in the Quran that Allah has forced us to do what He wanted us to do. Well, you're going to say, oh, there is that ayah that says, Wallahu khalaqakum wa ma ta'amaloon, Allah has created you on all your deeds. And Allah is going to say, really, did I say that? Is that what I meant? So if that is what I meant, that I created you on what you're going to do, so why there is a judgment day? Well, then you will understand that what Allah was saying back then is that He created you and all the actions that you are capable of doing. Example, a snake. Can a snake smile? Can he laugh? Can he actually joke? No. Why? Because Allah did not create in the instinct of a snake laughter and jokes. But He created us, created them for us. That's why we can laugh, we can joke, because Allah created us and created for us what we can do. He did not force us to laugh, but He created laughter. You can laugh if you want to, because you are capable of doing that. That's what it means. The Sheikhs, the Hadith, they changed what Allah meant so that the story of Muawiyah being the king lives on. Until today, all the rulers, governors, and everybody that comes to power is protected in Islam. Why? Because once the crown prince of Saudi Arabia, even if he kills Jamal Khashoggi brutally the way he assassinated him, well, it was written for Jamal Khashoggi to die like that. And it was written for crown prince to kill Jamal Khashoggi the way he did. Because why? Allah wrote it. Really? Is that how you're going to answer Allah on Judgment Day? Well, for your information, Allah never ever said in the Quran that we are forced to sin, because Allah plainly and simply said it, وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ. Allah is never pleased nor satisfied that His subservients, the humans, should disbelieve or commit sins. And as such, it all is in our hands. As such, Allah is innocent from all human actions. That's why there is a judgment day. And I beg of you to open your mind, because there is intelligence. That intelligence can be fed by the Quran. Study the Quran as an email sent to you from Allah directly. Forget what the scholars said, forget what the hadith say, read what Allah says. A researcher, a current researcher who also did long studies about the existence of Al-Bukhari, and many other researchers today reached the conclusion that Al-Bukhari does not exist, but they did it with the codicology, and that is the study of books. And the history, how, you know, when they take a document and they study how long it's existed, they say 2,000 years, whatever. Well, they study the books and they, again, scientifically, Al-Bukhari never existed. Politically, it never existed. Everything as you look at it. Okay, Al-Bukhari is just a compilation of texts that forced us to abandon the Quran and just believe in what this or that hadith say. Asked a scholar, he told him, because the other scholar came and it was like a debate, and he asks him, Your Highness, Your Eminence, Your blah, blah, blah. And you see, if you want to get one of those big sheikhs into the net, just give them big titles before their names and then they become totally dumbs and idiots. So he asked him, Ya Sheikh, if we took away the Quran today, we started a long, long campaign to remove the Quran from the lives of people, so much so that in 10 years' time, there will not be any Quran in existence, not on the internet, nowhere, nobody's going to talk about the Quran. Will Islam change or stay the same? And the Sheikh said, well, Al-Islam would always be the same. Nothing is going to hinder Al-Islam. Nothing's going to happen. And then the researcher asked the academician, asked the other guy, the sheikh, and he told him, what if we remove the hadiths and the books of hadith and the sayings of scholars, and we only kept Al-Quran and we acted on the book of our God sent to us? Will Al-Islam change? The sheikh told him, 100% yes. Al-Islam will be totally different than what it is today. And that is the plain truth. The true Islam is in Al-Quran and Al-Quran alone. Anything else is a human added manipulative and controlling techniques. So, anyone that claims that Allah has predetermined a human's actions is making Allah an accomplice in every murder, child abuse and sex exploitation, war, money laundering, women abuse, rape, marital cheating, parental abuses, lies, deceit, transgression, oppression, pride, envy, greed, theft, fornication. And again, that Allah wrote the whole movie, directed it, and on Judgment Day will ask us about our lousy performance and takes us to hell for eternity, or about our good performance and takes us to paradise eternally. This is not how Allah works. That's why my dear sisters and my brothers, Allah is innocent one more time from all humans' actions. And on Judgment Day, you will be held accountable on your choices. Open your mind. There is intelligence in it. I invite you to listen to the rest of the series. Again, this is your brother Abdul Salam Abu Hanifa, and my YouTube channel is Islam Pep Talk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.